really want to solve a lot of the governance issues in the city, in the state, I think it is about by the citizens, of the citizens, for the citizens. I've spent time with Abdul Kalam. He also, in his own way, I've had very good inspirational time with him. Politics is not for me because I do not subscribe to any single ideology.
Yours was perhaps a startup when you began with.
Yeah, I always pride my. I always pride myself that I perhaps was the first startup.
The word startup in India was not coined. The concept was not there, and we know what you said on the budget day. So, what do you have? Is there a message, or is do you think you know?
No, I think they've done a lot for the startup economy. I think it's good what they've done for the startup economy. You know, I think they do need to do a lot more because it's not easy to start a company. It's not easy to scale a company.
Yes.
So today, of course, it's much easier to start a company. But I think startups need a lot more help than what we think, you know. It's not just about giving them access to markets. It's about people investing in them so that they access markets.
Right.
It's about people investing in startups.
Right.
So, you know, I've seen the government has done a lot for startups, but why hasn't private sector VCs done enough for startups?
Right.
So we get all these knee-jerk reactions to any new concept in terms of mobility platforms. So if you look at what's happening today, regulators are just coming down very hard on these new models, right? Like if you look at Uber and Ola, these are new mobility models, but it's a very exciting mobility model because, you know, you don't have to add more cars to the traffic because these are about using existing vehicles in a very optimal way where the owners of the vehicle are able to, in a very flexible way, provide mobility services.
Right.
Right. And it's a very interesting thought that if you actually move to these on-demand shared mobility platforms, which are, you know, accessible through an app on your phone, then basically you can make mobility very seamless. You can actually start addressing traffic congestion. You can start addressing last mile connectivity of mass rapid transport. And so on and so forth. And you should actually work towards finding those kind of solutions.
Right.
Like that. So I think we need to look at these models to solve many of our problems. And I've come to the conclusion that if you really want to solve a lot of the governance issues in the city, in the state, I think it is about by the citizens, of the citizens, for the citizens. Unless citizens come together to solve their problems, I don't think it's, you know, reasonable to even expect that the government regulators know how to do it.
Right.
This was a filthy, polluted, dead lake, okay, called Hebbagodi Lake. And if you go and see Hebbagodi Lake today, it is beautiful. It is pristine. There is fish. There is birds. There, it looks beautiful now. There's so much water and we've created one walking path around it. We've created a playground there. We've done so much. And you should see how these kids are so happy because, you know, in the past, that was a garbage dumping ground and we converted that into a playground.
Who's been the greatest influencer?
No, I think, I don't think I can call. No, I don't think I've looked at individuals in that sense.
Right.
But I have obviously admired various people at different times.
Right.
You know, so I think if you ask me who inspired me earlier on, I think definitely Mr. Vagul, who believed in me and supported me in growing my business.
Yes,
Dr. Mashelkar, with whom I used to brainstorm about research and innovation. You know, that was an inspiration for me. I've spent time with Abdul Kalam. He also, in his own way, I've had very good inspirational time with him. And then, of course, people like Devi Shetty, people like Azim Premji, people like Narayan Murthy, you know, they've all been very good friends of mine, Nandan Nilekani, we are all, you know, yeah, we've inspired each other, I would say that way.
Kiran, have you ever considered joining politics?
That is one thing I will never join. Politics is not for me.
Because not even a Rajya Sabha.
No. I mean, Rajya Sabha is different, but politics is not for me because I do not subscribe to any single ideology.
Right.
I like to have a very open mind about different ideologies. I might like things from here, things from there, things from somewhere. But I don't I'm not the kind of person who subscribes to one ideology. Engaging with the political ecosystem, but engaging because I want to have better governance.
Yeah.
That I think will build pride in the country.